doctor Dan here.
Today's Sunday, so we've got another vlog lined up for you today. Decided in the interest of trying to save time, I've got my blog notes on a separate source than my internet resources, etc., so on and so forth. So I'm in a new video space. That's going to be one thing that we're going to cover. I was going to give you guys a tour, but I'm kind of still trying to figure out how I like everything organized. I got a new atomizer. I go over it first impression section-ish type thing. It's the Hellboy. By Tobacco. It's pretty awesome. Some advocacy stuff, Bill 45 in Ontario. Viewer question, back to basics. I'm going to do a quick old school coil build, something that I used to do. Throw it on the old Velocity and throw it on the Sigelli. We'll do a retro-ish section type thing. So, without any further ado, let's get into the Hellboy ad. Now, I was always kind of against square RDAs. Not really against them, but I didn't think that they would look quite this cool, to tell you the truth. I thought that I would have problems with them always being sort of off-center and kind of angular like that, and I like things to line up and be nice and flush and stuff. And it comes out pretty cool on this. I got it because I'm getting that custom-made box mod from Acer Mods. And it's going to be blue, so I wanted a blue Addy. And this one was at Cold Turkey, and it was relatively inexpensive, too. $28 for this bad boy. Airflow is amazing. The build deck is pretty sweet. That's part I really like about it. I can just pull off this top part, and I can see right down into my coils. And juice it up like that. Airflow adjusts just by spinning that thing. It doesn't impede too much on the build deck that I found. I threw one build in here, and I've just been rocking it ever since. I kind of love it. Tried working with ribbon wire for the first time, and it's kind of cool. It looks kind of like a bug leg. I don't know if you can hear that in the background. The pipes. And I'm raving this piece by Five Monkeys. It's called Frostbite. Met the guy who makes this, and we were talking about another one of his mythologies is Equinox. And this one here, it's just like I've got some notes. I'm gonna do a review on it a little later on. Got some notes on it. I think my first note was, holy menthol Batman. Yeah, holy menthol Batman. Like, I was amazed, at the menthol flavor of this. It's like, I don't know. I don't know how to describe it. It's like that first breath of cold air you get after a big snowfall. I can just like, it's almost like that feeling you get when you have a Halls or something, and that your throat just opens up and you feel like, yeah, you can breathe so much easier. It's a great juice. Kind of love it. Alright. So that aside, that's the Hellboy. Right, we're gonna jump up close. Take a look at all the post stuff. Sorry, my headphones are going crazy here. Because my TV is paused. We're gonna dive up close. Get to know the ins and the outs. Just to have a quick look at it. Again, not a full review, so just gonna quickly go over it. All right, here we go. Here's the Hellboy atomizer by Tobacco. I'm gonna show you the box contents. Comes with some extra O-rings. Does not come with any extra post screws. I noticed this little. Let's just show you the packaging here. Da 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 da. Little blue sticker. Show that I got the blue one. Pretty nice, clean packaging. There, your Addy comes in there. Comes with this standard sort of chuffy style drip tip. Not quite chuff, actually. It's just it's its own kind of drip tip, and it does come out of there, I think. Yep. So you can use your own drip tip with it if you like. I find I just kind of like that one as it is. Does also come with this kind of cool black, very wide bore drip top. It's just huge. I haven't tried it out yet. I just kind of like the looks of that one. Airflow does spin around by spinning this whole dealy. Then you can pull that out. See down into your coils there. Nice flathead screwdrivers. Flathead screws. And these O-rings are ridiculously strong on it. It's got a nice little section there where the deck sort of just fits in to that. And as you can see, you've got your 6 air holes right there. So nice raised stylizing. Hellboy, it says right there. I think it's kind of cool. And then this kind of cool demon-y face type thing. The post holes are pretty decently sized. Not huge, but decent. It could fit. I've got some ribbon clapped in there going on. Let's see if I can sort of push this aside and show you that post hole right there. So not huge post holes, but decently sized. Fairly shallow juice well. Let's see if I can get my fingers down there. It's about that deep. Not a terribly deep juice well. I guess it's not overly shallow either. It's kind of middle of the road. These O-rings are very strong. It's very strong. It's not going to fall off. Even if I shake it around violently. I haven't found that I've had any problems with this screwing down on an angle like that. It usually ends up pretty flush. One second. If I can get that back down on there now. There we go. Ends up pretty flush. Nice. Let's show you the 510 here now. Doo-doo-doo. So that, I do not believe it is adjustable at all. It does protrude a little bit. I would feel comfortable using it on a hybrid mod. Some people might not be. But I believe if you unscrew that, it just loosens off the center post there. So, I haven't really tried to adjust it at all. Airflow snaps in, and again, doesn't impede terribly too much on your build deck. Sorry, that's covered in juice. Doesn't impede too much, but you can fully adjust this either for single or dual coil, and it does close off all the way.
If you wanted to, I don't believe that you can suck through it. Well, maybe you can. Oh, because it's slightly open there. It does have a fairly wide, swooshy airflow when it's all the way open. So yeah, that is the tobacco, and there's no other pieces. Like I said, it did not come with any sort of, extra post screws, which I'm not a huge fan of, but, yeah. So one thing I didn't talk about is, it's got this one flat section here on one side, two corresponding air holes, and then corresponding with the flat section, it's got a single airflow option. So, you can rock this with a single coil and, have the airflow, work accordingly. So that is the up close and personal look at that. Let's see if I can get this back on to my EVIC. Here we go. Right on. Look at that. See, screws down nice and perfect every time. I haven't had one time where it's gone off on an angle. Nope. Not really a gap in there at all. I think that's more just from the it not being pushed down all the way on the O-rings. Yeah, see, like that just kind of pops back up a little bit. But it's just from the O-rings, I think. So, and having too much juice on it. So that is the up-close personal look. Let's get back out. There we go. Let's get back out and vape it and talk about it a little bit.
All right, so that was the Hellboy. Up-close and personal. It's pretty awesome so far. Love the airflow options. Just an all-around pretty great little addy. That is out of juice. Wasn't partial to the squareness of it at first, but I kind of it's growing on me. I like it. It looks pretty cool. Why won't this open? There we go. Juicer up. Alright. Yeah, so it's kind of an awesome little dealy. I'll have more on it in about a month or so. Maybe two. Got a fairly full up review queue here. But it'll get done on the Friday review in the future. We'll take a deeper look at it. I don't want to spend too much time on it right now. I do like all of the options that you can have for airflow. It is a little tight if you go down to one sort of column there. But yeah, it's pretty great airflow options. So that is the Hellboy by Tobacco again. Next, I've got the Built 45 in Ontario. And I'm gonna be that guy for a minute. I'm going to read you an article I found on Built 45 in Ontario. They had a rally yesterday on Saturday. I'm not sure how much more they're going to be doing, but take a look at the Ontario. Oh shoot, I have them on my Instagram. I'll put a link in the description. There's an Instagram page and there's a website for them. There's a advocacy group in Ontario. They did a march yesterday. They marched down to Parliament to go and tell their stories and go and do some advocacy stuff. So I'm just gonna read this article here on Law Times, Law Times News. Sorry, one second. Let me just get this. LawTimesNews.com. I'll put a link in the description. So you can check out the article if you want. I'm just going to read part of it, because it's a fairly lengthy article. Oh, actually, it's not too bad. thought it was longer. So, Ontario's proposed legislation to control the use of e-cigarettes is unconstitutional, according to the University of Ottawa law professor. If Bill 45 passes, oh, sorry, if it passes, Bill 45 will make it illegal to display or promote the use of e-cigarettes and impose age and place restrictions around its use. Much like the current rules around e-cigarettes, the bill cites uncertainties over the medical effects of e-cigarettes. According to the adjunct law, Professor David Sweener, according to adjunct law professor David Sweener, the bill, which is also known as Making Healthier Choices Act, that's kind of funny, will limit people's ability to make a healthier choice by replacing regular cigarettes with e-cigarettes. Sweener, who's worked in health policy on tobacco and nicotine for 30 years, says allowing unrestricted use of e-cigarettes could save an untold number of lives. He says, by and large, the harm in smoking is the smoke itself, which is absent in e-cigarettes. Banning the display of e-cigarettes would, in effect, a ban on the use of the product, according to Sweener, who adds consumers would need to see and try e-cigarettes if they are to use them. There are things one needs to know about how to charge batteries, how to replace parts, how to fill it, and people need to sample it if they're getting the one that's right for them, he says. If we preclude people from doing what we've effectively prevented them from being able to have a less hazardous product, Sweener adds, noting that goes against a person's charter-protected right to life. Unlike buying cigarettes, which are more or less the same, e-cigarettes are a bit like picking out a pair of running shoes or a cell phone. To say we're treating them the same as smoking, in fact, gives smoking an advantage because the nature of the product, but also misinforms consumers into thinking that these things must be as hazardous as smoking rather than being told the truth, which is that they're massively less hazardous than smoking, Sweener adds. I think I like this Sweener guy. But speaking at recent Ontario Bar Association session on health law, two Ministry of Health lawyers explained the government's point of view in drafting the legislation. Donna Glassman said e-cigarettes are popular among youth, with 15% of students grades 7 to 12 reporting having tried them. I'm sure more than 15% have tried cigarettes by that age. Like, I think I was in grade 8 or 9 when I tried cigarettes the first time. And I know people who have started younger than that. Where was I? I lost myself. Okay, there we go. There was a huge concern that it would become a gateway to cigarettes themselves, she said, adding that they're easy to access and there's currently no age-based restriction on their use. Well, that's just a flat-out lie. I mean, most people, and I mean, if you're being a good vendor, then there is a 18-plus or 19-plus, whatever the provincial or state legislation is on it. I flipped the tablet and it moved. Age restriction. Yeah, you should. I mean, yeah, like, that's just a no-brainer. Okay, so next we got, where was I now? Age-based restriction. Okay, here we go. The government's concern is also that e-cigarettes would result in renormalization of smoking indoors, said Glassman, adding, the World Health Organization has recommended the regulation of vapor-based devices. Maybe regulation, but not quite to this extent, I don't think. Last one's colleague Marcus Mazucco. Mazuko? Matsuko? I don't know. Marcus Mazuko said that ministry has received concerns from members of the public who are worried about the effect of people smoking e-cigarettes. Smoking e-cigarettes in the workplace. I don't like that statement as a whole. It's not smoking e-cigarettes at all. It's vaping. I mean, it's not smoke at all. There is no combustion going on. It doesn't make smoke. The scientific evidence is limited. The fact that they're a new product and they're evolving, said Mazzucato, noting the long-term impact of using e-cigarettes isn't known. Well, vaping hasn't been around long enough for it to really be known, all of the side effects. That's just a plain and simple fact. I mean, yeah, we can do some testing. I mean, there's been lots of studies going on in the UK. And I'll put a link to the THRA site, down below. They've got lots of resources on all the studies that have been done, in the UK and stuff like that. Supreme Court has made it clear a reasonable apprehension of harm is sufficient to take precautionary measures. To Sweener, that there is some harm to using e-cigarettes should not result in a restriction on the use of it. He argues much of the pushback against e-cigarettes comes from moralistic abstinence-only approach. There's nothing we do that's completely risk-free. Yeah. Yeah. Nothing in your life. Nothing in your life is risk-free. You could choke on a piece of gum. You could trip on your shoelace walking down the street. Nothing you do is risk-free. Has to be seen in terms of relative risk. We know the science, the relative risk of these products is very low. Yes. Instead of taking action based on some studies that point out at the problems with e-cigarettes, the government should read all available studies and the critiques of those studies, suggests Sweener. Yes. Yes, Sweener gets it. They will find that most of the reports about the hazards of e-cigarettes are from people who are fear-mongering about them, or people who have a prohibitionist agenda, or they just don't like e-cigarettes for competitive reasons, i.e. big tobacco, etc. Just like the debate on vaccines, some of the conversation around e-cigarettes is based on science, and the rest is garbage. Sweener adds, yes, okay. Banning e-cigarettes is a bad public health move, he says. Sweener gets it. According to the Action on Smoking and Health, there are 2.1 million users of electronic cigarettes in the United Kingdom. Of those, approximately one-third are ex-smokers, while two-thirds continue to use tobacco alongside electronic cigarettes, according to the ASA. Compared with smoking, using an electronic cigarette is safer. However, in the absence of a thorough clinical evaluation and long-term population-level surveillance, absolute safety of such products cannot be guaranteed by the comparison. By comparison, the harm of tobacco smoking, the leading cause of preventable death in the UK, is well established, says the ASH. A cigarette's the only consumer product when used as directed kills its consumer. It's a no-brainer to me. Sweener compares e-cigarettes to safe injection sites for those with intravenous drug addiction. It's not the drug, but the delivery of the drug that causes the biggest public health problem, he says. Correction, the original version of this article suggested Ottawa is proposing Bill 45 when it's in fact provincial legislation. Okay, so this isn't a Canada-wide issue, but it could very well become one. I mean, our capital is in Ontario. This is something that could affect vaping all over Canada. And we need to come together on this, guys. If you're in Ontario and you're watching this, go to the link down below for the Ontario... Oh, shoot. I can't remember. It'll be in the description. I'll put a link to it. I can't remember because I'm an asshole. It's serious. Serious, serious, serious. Fight for your rights. Fight for your rights. It's a no-brainer. And I don't want to sound like one of those conspiracy theorists with the tinfoil hats, but fight for your damn rights. You are. It's your right as a Canadian. It's your right as a vapor. Just do it. Just do it. Okay, next. Got some shoutouts. I have my buddy in Edmonton has a band. It's been going for a little while. It's some sick metal. I'll put a link in the description below. Let's see if... I'm just going to start a new cut here in case YouTube decides to mute me, then I'll still have the videos to play without playing the music. Whoops. So they're called Tales of the Tomb. It's some psychological horror metal is the description they have on the Metal Underground. Oh, Tales. I started typing metal. Oh my gosh, Xbox. Tales of the. Tales of the Tomb. There we go. Where is... Oh, there's their channel. Let's just go to their channel. I'm subscribed, by the way. You should too. They only have... What? They only have two of their songs up here? Oh, where's no time? All right, I'm gonna just crank this. Turn this on here. Crank this. You should be able to hear it. Let's do Pig Farmer. Yeah, the song is called Pig Farmer. It's kind of badass. Okay, maybe you can't hear it through this. One second. Turn the volume way down. Sorry. Okay, here we go. Start it over. Thank you.
didn't start a new cut. Oh, well. So, yeah. That's my buddy Connor. Singing is badass. Like, it's just the video is awesome. It's all about Robert Picton. It's so badass. If you haven't checked him out, check him out. I'll put a link in the description below. You're badass. Okay, so that's Tales of the Tomb. Shout out to my buddy Connor. You guys' band kicks ass. I was there when my bro was working on a couple of these songs, and it's awesome. It's like some sick face melting metal. Tales of Tomb. Connor. Shout out. Oh yeah, their EP just dropped on the 27th of last month. So if you like them, check them out. And you can pick up their EP. Next I got Misty Meow. Misty Meow on Instagram. She does some sweet art. So really awesome art. And I just I noticed she had liked one of my photos, I think, and then I kind of went all creeper on it and like started scrolling through her pictures, and she's got some sick art. oh, sorry, menthol. One sec. There we go. Much better. It's awesome. Like, I'll put up some pictures, and like maybe here or here or here or here or here or here. I don't know. my editor software just got this new thing where I can put pictures in the screen, and I'm all super stoked. I'm not sure how to do it yet. This will be the first time trying it, so wish me luck. So yeah, I'm gonna try to put one right here. This is the one that first caught my attention. If it's not right here, then you could just laugh at me for doing this right now. It's kind of funny. At least I think it is. Anyways, at Misty Meow. Meow has 2 W's. Check her out. She's got sick Instagram. Sick art. Check her out. Shout out to Misty Meow. Okay, so now my third shout out is actually to Mark from Five Monkeys. Hooked me up with Frostbite. We were just talking about menthol juices and how, like, I like to use them sort of, like, as a palate cleanser. So when I get, like, vape tongue from my all-day vape and I just stop tasting it, oops, I just take a couple puffs of menthol usually, and it helps clear that up. We were talking about Equinox and, which is also another menthol tobacco flavor. And I'm not sure if they make any more, but it's really good. It's almost got like a little bit of a chocolatey flavor to it too. And yeah, he just hooked me up with this Frostbite, and it's kind of amazing. They have it at Cold Turkey, so if you're interested, go check it out. It's friggin' delicious. If you love menthol, like, if you used to be a menthol smoker, I was an occasional menthol smoker. Like, I'd smoke regular cigarettes for the most part, and then every now and again, I'd like a menthol cigarette just to, like, switch it up. And anytime I was sick, it was menthol all the time. Five Monkeys, Frostbite.
Check it out. They got it in cold turkey. It's freaking delicious. I got the airflow wide open on this Hellboy, and I'm still getting ridiculous flavor on this frostbite. And it's not just minty like a lot of menthol juices are. It's just, it's good. Like, it's menthol. Like, it's what I expect when I'm trying a new menthol. And I'm always let down, because I always taste, like, spearmint or peppermint. Oh, I just love that feeling that I get off in my chest after. Like, it's cool, and it's almost like I had, like, Vicks Vapo Rub all over me, and then, like, went outside and took a nice, cool breath of air. Yeah, so, Fire Monkeys, big shout-out. It also kind of ties into my viewer question. So, Carl, good friend of mine, suggested that I do a giveaway. And I didn't want to ruin the surprise, but I'm going to anyways. I am going to be doing a giveaway. It's going to be coming up in not too long. Actually, Five Monkeys has agreed to be a bit of a juice sponsor for it. So, haven't quite worked out all of the details yet. But that will be coming when I hit 1,000 Instagram followers, which will be coming up pretty soon. I think I'm just about 830, 840, maybe. So, like, I'm getting, like, ridiculous amounts per day, even. So, that could be by next vlog. It could be by the vlog after that. But, yeah, there's going to be a giveaway. So, I was going to wait for, like, a YouTube sort of, what is the word I'm looking for? A YouTube benchmark? No. I can't remember the word that I'm looking for right now for some reason. I was going to wait until I got to, like, 500 YouTube subs, but 1,000 Instagram subscribers, or followers, rather, is coming up pretty quickly. So, that is going to be when I do the giveaway. I got some ideas. I'm going to pick up a mech mod, I'm going to pick up an Addy, and I'm going to pick up a battery. And the winner is going to get those and some juice. Yeah. So that's, and I'll even throw in a build. I'll build something on it, and yeah, that'll go to the giveaway winner. The giveaway is going to be done on my Instagram, but the winner is going to be announced on the vlog. So that's coming. That is coming. Back to basics. So let's see here. Do I have, where is my, there we go. My handy dandy old coils. This is just a Tic Tac container. I'm way too Scottish to throw away any of my old coils. We're going to dump this out right now. We're going to pick out one of my old coils. I think I have one from back. Yeah, right there. That is janky as hell. Wow. It's like a trip down memory lane looking at all these, checking out all the different coil builds I tried to do. Holy crap, that's gunked up. That is just gross. I wouldn't clean the coils. I would just build a new one. Like, look how gunked up that is. I'm going to be that guy for a second. Can you see that? Of course not. It's way too dark. But it's, like, black and caked. So, yeah, I'm going to grab my velocity.
And my Sigali.
And we're gonna jump into this section right meow.
The first coil ever built, and it's got wicked hot spots. So I'm just gonna give it a little bit of a fiddle. There we go. This coil is a 0.3 ohm coil, twisted 26 gauge, very loosely twisted. I don't know if you're going to be able to see that. I'll throw a picture up somewhere over here. Yeah, sorry. let's get some wick going here. We're going to go retro. We're going to use the Sapiba. I've been trying out this new stuff, cotton bacon. I guess this is gonna be like another first impression. I've been trying this cotton bacon stuff out. It comes in this like little Ziploc bag, and it's just like a bunch of these massive pads. It's kind of like the Shiseido and it's like sort of consistency. If you were to take off the outer, like hardened pads, but it's also kind of fibrous, like the Sapima. I don't know. I'm kind of liking it. It's cotton bacon. I got it at Cold Turkey for $15 for this pack, and it's just like, it's a lot. It's a lot of wick. I've made probably like 30 wicks just messing around already with it. And it's good stuff. I like it a lot. It's a lot easier to work with than the Sapima, I find. And it absorbs stuff faster than the Sapima, which leads me to believe that it can't really hold as much as the Sapima, but that is pure speculation at this point. Let's see, I need about that much. I'm still doing more science-y stuff with it. Trying to test it out. Jeez. It's been a long time since I've used this, actually. I've been using the cotton bacon for this last, I don't know, week or so. And, all of the stuff that has the Sapima cotton in it already, Sapima cotton lasts so long that you barely ever have to re-wick. Well, with the amount that I change stuff around anyways, I hardly ever have to rewick, because I just switch different, just use a different mod for the time being. Where am I? Here we go. Tweezers. That was probably way more cotton than I needed. It'll work. Just tuck that down into the base there. Into the adjust well. Right on. Okay, so get that. We're gonna get some juice happening. Let's do this sort of a fruity blend mix. Some, I don't know, like watermelon and lychee. It's Theravape lychee. Some unknown juice that my buddy Nick gave me. It was just too strong for him. And, like, it was a strong juice. So first I tried mixing it down with some six milligram to tone it down. And,
Then I used, kind of like vaped it down a bit, but it was still ridiculously strong. So, holy smokes, this should say, or this Supima holds a lot of juice. We got vapors. I'm amazed this coil still works. Top cap here. Click her down into place. Got a robot happy face going on. And this is how I vape when I got my first RDA. So. Wow. It's not bad. Let's see. I think, yeah, so 0.3 ohms. Somehow, I think it was 0.2 ohms when I first got it, and I was vaping it at 12 watts, I remember. Mostly because somebody made a funny comment on my video. It's like, well, 0.2 ohms at 12 watts, and you're a cloud chaser? Haha. No, just busting your balls. It was funny. It was really funny. I think it was Berserk something. I don't know. It kind of made my day. Do I still have it up in the background? My Google Plus is up. We might be able to get to it. Mr. Berserk. I'm not gonna give you the numbers, etc. after his name. But yeah, he kinda made my day. It was kinda hilarious. Because yeah, I was vaping 0.2 at 12 watts. I'm getting on 0.3 at 12 watts, I'm getting 2.1 volts. Wow. Clouds. That's hilarious. Okay, I'm gonna crank that back up. All the way at 50 now. Dude, watts, it's not that bad of a vape, actually. Yeah, so that was that. That was the thing. Okay. So we went over the new video space, went over the Hellboy Addy, went over Ontario Bill 45. We didn't do what up tugboat. I'm getting a tugboat. I'm so excited. I always see my favorite YouTube reviewer rocking a tugboat. And I just was at Cold Turkey hanging out, and I asked if they were getting tugboats in. And one of the guys there said, "Hey, I got an extra tugboat. I'm not using anymore." So he's giving it to me for a screaming deal. Like, screaming, screaming deal. Chris, yeah, you didn't get a shout out. Shout out to Chris, because I'm going to go get myself a tugboat today. Well, it's tomorrow, but I mean, it'll be today when this video comes out. So yeah, shout out to Chris, from Cold Turkey, hooking me up with a tugboat at a screaming deal. What up, tugboat? Can't wait. Super stoked. We did shout outs, we did a viewer question, and we did back to basics. So, that being said, this vlog is just about wrapped up. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, even suggestions, I'm still pretty new to this whole YouTube review game, and I love input. So let me know in the comments below what you think I could have done better, what you thought of the video, if you thought it was informative, if you thought it was a bunch of mindless babble. Either way, let me know. All input is appreciated. in the comments below. If you're excited about the giveaway, get more excited because I'm working on some cool deals and there will be more giveaways to come. What else? Hellboy. What up, Hellboy? see, what do we got going on? Oh, yeah. Join us on Friday, if you so desire. This week coming up, we're going to do the Nightcore i2 charger. Where's the box? That's my... It's my charger that I got. The only one that I've really tried so far. It's the 2014 version. We're going to be covering this in the Friday review. Week after that, we're going to be doing the Velocity. And I got a whole schedule lined up right to the end of February. Yeah, I'm all the way to the beginning of March. I'm all scheduled up. So we're going to have a review a week on Fridays, talking about a piece of hardware. I'm thinking about throwing a juice review somewhere during the week. Maybe Wednesday. Maybe Thursday. Thursday? No. I don't know. Let me know in the comments below. What you think? What day would be good for a juice review day? Juice reviews, hardware reviews. What else we got? I didn't really make all of the notes. I just kind of tried to make rough notes. I just have a page here of notes. So there's gonna be links in the description, all the stuff I just talked about. Let me know what you think, what day would be good for a juice review. Input is appreciated. Any comments, questions, concerns, suggestions, everything. If you just want to chat, I always respond. You can hit me up on my social media. I'm Vape Dr. Dan on everything, so Instagram at Vape Dr. Dan, Twitter at Vape Dr. Dan. Jeez, Lou, all one word. Facebook, you can find me as Vape Dr. Dan. I set it to my nickname, so you can search me. I also have a page as Vape Dr. Dan on Facebook. I'm also on Tumblr as Vape Dr. Dan. What else am I on? Well, you've seen my channel, obviously. If not, then check out the rest of the videos there. I've got some stuff. It's you can join me on my vaping journey all the way from when I started getting into mods. I got my first mod, started watching all sorts of YouTube reviewers, got the bright idea to start doing it myself. goes all the way back to my first little setup of the... Let's see. One second. If I can take this Velocity off. My very first mod setup. Right here. Sigelli 50 Watt and the Atlantis V2. That's the very first one. Yeah. Right on. Thanks for joining. I really do appreciate all of the viewers. All of the comments. Really do appreciate them. Hope to see you again soon. Next Sunday, we'll be doing another vlog. Hopefully this one isn't too long. I'm trying to get all my videos down a little bit shorter. But I sort of start to ramble like I'm doing right now. Friday review is going to be nice, shorter videos. probably, I'm going to try to keep them around 10 minutes. 10 to 15-ish. Vlog going to be a little longer because we got a lot of stuff to talk about. Juice reviews. I'm going to be doing a Walter Weiss one soon. I was talking with the guys from Walter Weiss, and they should have something middle of next week-ish for me. So, I should have, I'm hoping that I get enough input to decide on a juice review day by the time I get the stuff. If not, then I'll just probably end up throwing a thumbtack at the calendar, and that'll be the day that I start doing juice reviews. That being said, check the links below, and remember, I'm gonna vape as I go out here, the Hellboy, and remember, stay smurfy. Get it eventually.